On May 26, 1969, newlyweds John Lennon and Yoko Ono staged their legendary Bed-In for Peace in their suite at the Queen Elizabeth Hotel in Montreal. It was the culmination of a whirlwind tour that began 2 months earlier and was soon to be immortalized in the Beatles song, The Ballad of John and Yoko. The song begins with a couple standing on the dock at Southampton, trying to get to Holland or France in an attempt to secure a wedding venue. John originally wanted to have the wedding on a boat crossing the English Channel en route to France, but complications arose and instead he opted to fly to Paris. After arriving in Paris on March 16th, the couple learned that they could not be married in France as they had not lived in the country long enough. Fortunately, Peter Brown, assistant to Beatles manager Brian Epstein, informed the couple that they could be married in the British territory of Gibraltar, so the couple set off. They were finally married at the British Consulate Office in Gibraltar on May 20th, 1969. John and Yoko then returned to Paris for their honeymoon. In the early morning of March 25th, the couple hired a car and were driven to Amsterdam, where they held their first bed-in at the Hilton Hotel. When reporters arrived, expecting to see John and Yoko engaged in intimate behavior, they were instead greeted by the pajama-clad couple in full recline, their bed surrounded by flowers and hand-painted signs. The couple were inundated with interviews for a full week before making a lightning trip to Vienna to attend the premiere of Rape, a film the couple wrote and directed. There, they also held a press conference, addressing the media from inside a large white bag while eating chocolate cake. On April 1st, John and Yoko returned to London. John met up with the rest of the Beatles to record their Abbey Road album. During this time, John and Yoko recorded an experimental track entitled John and Yoko, which would end up becoming the first side of their wedding album. After deciding to hold a second bed-in, this time across the pond, the couple flew to the Bahamas on May 24th. But after one night in a Freeport hotel, they realized the country was too hot and too far away from the United States to attract enough media. With New York off-limits to John because of the previous drug possession charge, the couple flew to Toronto, where they stayed overnight before traveling to Montreal to begin their second bed-in. The couple checked into the Queen Elizabeth Hotel on May 26th and began receiving guests and giving interviews, sometimes up to 150 per day. On June 1st, in their hotel room, John and Yoko recorded Give Peace a Chance. The session was captured on 4-track and featured a backing ensemble including comedian Tommy Smothers, poet Allen Ginsberg, LSD crusader Timothy Leary and his wife Rosemary Woodruff, singer Petula Clark, civil rights advocate Dick Gregory, cartoonist Al Capp, Rabbi Abraham Feinberg, and members of the Canadian Radha Krishna Temple. The party couldn't last forever though, and 10 days after they checked in, John and Yoko's amnesty period in Canada expired, and they were deported back across the Atlantic. Nonetheless, the Montreal bed-in was a success, attracting a frenzy of media coverage to promote the couple's message of peace.
I think the only way to do it is Gandhi's way, and that's non-violent, passive, positive, or whatever they called it those days.
Peace.
Peace in your mind, peace on earth, peace at work, peace at home, peace in the world.